Yeah, so that's been the kind of standard talking point, and it's been interesting that some of the pesticide companies have actually formed divisions to study honeybees, which from a cynical standpoint, I would have to say is simply to further this narrative that the bees are dying, you know, from self-inflicted wounds caused by Varroa or by, you know, viruses vectored by the Varroa. So you cannot deny that the bees are dying from Nosema and from viruses. You know, that's, we see that all the time. What was really interesting when I put together all the research for the VBA presentation to the AIB was to look at the studies examining the synergies between pesticide exposure and Nosema and pesticide exposure and viruses. And what these researchers have found is exactly what we've seen in the bees, which is levels of virus, levels of mite exposure, which the bees used to shrug off and they would survive just fine. They no longer shrug off. Beekeepers are having to treat at much lower thresholds of mite levels than they used to. And seemingly healthy bees that are showing no outward signs of virus infection are dying over the winter in a way that shows it's a slow attrition of sick bees rather than a sudden freeze or starvation or something like that. And so to me, it's pretty clear that it's the synergies that are causing the viruses and the Nosema to become much more lethal than it used to be. And that is borne out by the research that's out there. So yes, they're right. The bees are dying from viruses. The bees are dying from Nosema. And they're doing it because they're also being exposed to pesticides. And without the pesticides, they might be able to survive these exposures, which are pretty much unavoidable. You can treat for Varroa, you can even treat for Nosema, you can breed resistance to Varroa, but you'll never eliminate it. It's a fact of life now.